Ngbaku, one of the communities in the capital of Anambra State, Awka, is still in shock over the violent attack on a member of the community, Madueze Orakulu. Mr. Orakulu, who was mobbed to death, was alleged to have used machete to hack Mrs. Teresa Obalum to death on her way to her usual early morning routine of distributing pap to customers. Angry villagers mobbed the suspect and his house ablaze. In spite of this, relatives of Mrs. Obalum are crying for justice.
Now this woman, they feed all of us. It's about to kill him this morning, destroy my family. What can I do? I don't know whether to drink poison and die. How can I do this to all these small children? We're there for primary school. Three of them there for primary school. Two of them there for secondary.
Mrs. Obalum, about 40 years of age, has been in the business for years. And according to the youth leader of the community, the mental health of the suspect cannot be ascertained.
It's high time we sit down and, you know, enlist those so-called mental health persons and, you know, hand them over to the appropriate authority where they will be taken care of.
The police public relations officer, Anambra Command, confirms the incident and condemns the killing of Mrs. Teresa Obalum while cautioning the youth over taking laws into their hands.
We deployed our men quickly to the place, and when they got to the place, the angry mob already set the suspect ablaze, and we recovered the corpse of the deceased woman and we have evacuated the body to Isuanocha Hospital. So I think what has happened there is quite unfortunate, but we have deposited the corpse for autopsy, and at the same time we'll go into a discreet investigation and we'll charge anyone found liable to such an act to court to face its course.
Calm has returned to the community as police has launched an investigation into the incident. But until then, the agony of the victims lingers as they await justice.